But in my corner of the internet, oversimplified is like the most Chad it gets. When he drops a video, the entire community just loses their mind. They definitely stop watching my videos. Oversimplified is like the Bob Ross of our niche. And if he's the Bob Ross, that would make me a skinny mustache man that failed art school. But to be honest, before this moment, I've only watched like 5 to 6 of his videos. I decided to binge watch. He watched for like 6 hours, and I'm gonna review and rank them in this tier list that I found. Every single video, I've got different categories: humor, education, quality. That's how we're ranking these. One thing that I was like just super shocked at is that no one dislikes these videos. It's pretty amazing to talk about history and to get, you know, like no dislikes almost. That's talent right there. Trust me. I got some videos that got destroyed. But his name is perfect because how could you be mad? He's saying it right there. He is oversimplifying the information. And today I'm gonna simp or oversimplified. Simp time. So we're gonna start in order. Video one. It was talking about no-no conflict number one. Like I said, one of the categories that I was writing things down, I was actually reading and writing. It's crazy. One of the categories that I was using that was quality. Some of these beginning videos, you know, it's beginning. I mean, they're better than mine, but I'm just saying. It was a little short. You can tell, like, I would love to see this video get revised, honestly. I think maybe we could use a remake. Only because it's such a big topic, and this was like the first video of his, so. I gotta have some, you know, I can't put them all at the very top. I'm gonna look too simping. It's crazy how great the animation became, too. But this, for 2016, this was all right. Disappointed, though, that there was no reference to anime. This event was massive for anime. It all led to anime. One thing I realized while watching this, though, is I could be, like, the laziest history teacher ever. One day, maybe I can be. I'm just gonna throw this on in the background, require my students to take notes, and give them a little test at the end of every video. Dude, job's done right there. You know what? Screw YouTube. I'm gonna get paid and do nothing. I'm ready to go. Yeah, these are like one of the only videos that I would like to see get remade. The next one in the series took a little bit of time. You can tell the writers, the season's writers, they were going hard for this one. It's funny because I said like some of the beginning videos are but this is probably one of my favorites. It's such a good like balance between humor, but when it gets serious, it can be serious. Like that's the key. That's so hard to do. Because obviously I can't do that. Bam, I'm giving that S and A tier. Really, like, so this is my first... Maybe it's because it was, like, my first diving into the channel. I'm not reviewing the content, by the way. I'm not reviewing the subject. I'm reviewing the creator. I want to point that out. Now, this anime is very different. Sometimes we have seasons. Sometimes we have spinoff episodes. And this was, like, the first spinoff episode, The Falklands. Good spinoff series. Love it. When he drops a video on a new subject, I swear the memes are just, like, solidified. Like... the memes are now going to be there forever because everyone knows about it. And the memes are still going years later. I had no idea the Falklands was like that bloody, that kind of crazy. Argentina, Britain, you guys, I didn't know there's all this, like, I knew it was haha, haha, Argentina man, funny. But you guys got pretty angry. I didn't realize that. Again, like, watching some of the later videos, like, the animation gets so good. We're still building up to that moment. We're still building the production quality. The anime gets more detailed, I promise, in the later seasons. I had no idea that, like, I thought, like, 3 people got shot. I didn't know it was this serious. Very good spinoff episode, but probably not as good as the second one. That's gonna get an A list right there. The football conflict? Yo, that one was wild. See, I've heard about all these topics, but to go into it deeper, that was, I think, most interesting to me. Obviously not super deep. I mean, it's oversimplified. This girl offed herself because she lost the soccer game. Her team lost the soccer game.
After the match, a young Salvadoran fan, unable to bear her country's defeat, shot herself. Disturbingly, the Salvadoran
fan
shot
herself because she lost the football game? Yo, yo.
Okay, I'm gonna give you a little hot, risky take here, but you know, this one was okay. I know this is gonna be the most famous arc in the anime, but I kind of knew about it already. Yeah, of course, these are his two most popular videos, and they will probably always be his two most popular videos. I have my personal list, which I'm not gonna rank them that high. But of course, let me know down below where you'd rank them at. Again, they're good videos, but it's just review for the most part. I'm a hipster. I like his deep cuts. His popular stuff? No, you gotta go deeper into the album. Boy, before you ruin me. I like that he actually includes historical images colorized. That's one of my favorite parts. Documentation of the event. It's just also lifelike. Didn't know they had HD cameras back then. I like how he dabbles in some of the like the breakdowns of the battles, and then it got better with time. Like, this is pretty general, but then he'll go way deeper. Like, you know how hard that takes to keyframe these flags to move around like that? That's actually some of my favorite moments, is breaking down the actual battles to show you what it was like. God mode status. Back to a spinoff episode number 3. Spinoff episode number 3. I remember this being titled something else. Did the title change? Stab. This is what I'm talking about right here. This is good information. Ground over the top And was like, yeah, this one definitely got up there in terms of quality. I think this was the beginning of some good stuff. I thought that that thumbnail said yeet for a second. Cow and then yeet. You gotta yeet cow sometimes. Probably gonna rank this one up near the Falklands. Good stuff, good stuff. I guess my ranking would be different if I was trying to like specifically tell someone that doesn't know much about any of these topics. It'd be very different actually. I'd probably tell them to go down this path first. But I'm assuming all of you guys that are watching this video right now know at least base knowledge. Basically, fancy talk happened because of the Normans. Oh, that's just fancy talk. If it wasn't for the Normans, I wouldn't be doing this. Pinky up! Cows, pork, sheep, or yeah, mutton, pork, beef. Yo, actually, I'm kind of mad at the Normans. We could have been actually talking like this. What? Where do you get off? I will forget it. I don't know if it's just because, like, I have a deep anger towards American history now because I was just taught it over and over and over again. But I have the same feeling that I had towards like UWU War II. Like I'd already learned about this, so the arc was kind of repeating a lot of stuff. Again, if you're new, go for it. American history is just DLC history. One thing I like is that you can rewatch these videos over and over again and always see something like new and clever in the background. There's a lot of clever stuff, so you can rewatch them and see references you didn't get before. Dang, he's looking so nice, so thick. How could you revolt from that, really? Yeah, again, C. I'm gonna just put them both in C, probably. I guess this is our flag for a little bit. Dude, this is just the Hawaiian flag. I like how the Hawaiian flag kind of kept this going a little bit. Can we just bring that back? Let's bring it back. I mean, I know that you don't have the correct amount of stars. We don't need all the stars. Dude, even little moments from these videos, I think, help tell enough people about, like John Paul Jones, the most Chad warrior ever, just float over to the British Isles, start raiding stuff. Even those little things, there's still memes about it, and I think, personally, it's because of these videos. It educates enough people, so, like, haha, I remember that. I didn't know about it before, though. Season 12 brought us a little bit of some stuff that I knew about, but it was so good that I can't rank it low. It's the emus! I've actually looked into this stuff myself. I don't know how you pulled 10 minutes out of this information, and it was all good. Like, I tried to make my own history video about this one time, and I looked into it, and I was like, there's just not enough here. But they found out how to make enough. It wasn't necessarily just Australians go into desert, start yeeting emus, but then end up giving up. Goes deeper than that, much deeper. I know this is, like, kind of obvious, too, but I found it probably as the funniest episode. I'm not just saying because haha, Big Bird's funny. I actually thought it was funny. There was moments in there that was funny. In terms of the spinoff episodes, that's gonna be up there for sure. Now this is one of those episodes you gotta be very careful about because this is brand new. This is a fresh wound. This arc is fresh in everyone's mind. So if anyone was gonna have a lot of dislikes, I thought it would be these. But nope, 97% and 98%. You know what? I think part two is better. It's interesting part two didn't get as many views. That just might be my own bias in the fact that I like that time in history. 70s, 80s. Like, I like that part of the conflict. Problem is, part one gave us quite possibly the greatest image. The greatest image. I forgot about this image. I don't think I can rank this that low just because of this one frame. This man's getting pretty low. Damn, I'm jealous. Dude, Kimmy just trying to be respectful with his hand right there. That's the respectful zone. Someone never taught this guy that that's you trying to hit. That's the wrong vibes. This episode literally could have been like the worst episode ever, but I don't care. It has this image. And then the universe, the oversimplified universe, just continues to revolve around itself. Similar scenes, other episodes, past references, foreshadowing. You'll see in the later episodes. Probably goes like this for me so far. Again, I probably could like bump them all up, but for the sake of it being interesting, like I do need to be like kind of hard on some of them. Lena was such a poet. Roses are red, violets are red. If you aren't red, you'll get shot in the head. What a poet, what a poet. I've been wondering about this. Like that's who I thought for a very long time. I think it might be. Bro, that's him. That's definitely him. He's like one of those Chads. He's definitely one of those history Chads. Bro, this is him coming up with the script for the next episode. There's no doubt in my mind it is. Or wait a second, maybe it's that. In terms of pure education, at least the education part of the review, this one had to have been like the hardest, I think. I found it at least very interesting because I barely knew any of this. I shudder at the thought of having to do the research for this thing. I noticed he hasn't done much else in terms of like history. Well, probably like older stuff. We're gonna see a Rome day. I'm gonna predict Caesar next. There's gonna be a Caesar video soon. Basically, the summary right here. European history, I'm too difficult. China history, am I a joke to you? I just like watched this whole video and just like numbers were like spinning around my head. I don't even know if I comprehended it. I don't even think I could follow along. It was like, I remember having difficulties watching this one. But for that reason, I mean, it's really being held up for that, just the depth. Yeah, this one gets a pretty high ranking because of the quality and education. Not too many ha-has, though. It needed more ha-has. But the French Revolution arc was one of the best animes, one of the best anime storytelling. Even if I did get spoiled and I knew the ending, it was still great. I think this is like when I rediscovered Oversimplified, and it made me realize that, wow, history teachers have the easiest job nowadays. Dude, all history teachers need to do is look up on YouTube, post some videos, make people play some history video games, and you're good. I also learned that the cake lady had a lot of cake. She talked about let them eat cake. Oh, I know what type of cake she was trying to get them to eat, at least according to the way this animation be looking down. Now that's the type of educational experience you usually have to pay extra for, but not here. What about this though? Come on now. All women are queens. I learned that the French were, if she breathes, she's, just making this video, I've been asked if I've watched the Revolution, Russian Revolution one, like, a dozen times. I'm not even joking. Ah, there he is again, photoshopping himself in there. This was probably the best, like, comedic one, in my opinion. Part one's getting that A tier, part two, getting the coveted S tier, OP tier. I like when he talked about Napoleon, because, you know, short kings, we rise up. My height will not stop me, guys. I won't let it happen. It's because I'm 4'9". Bro, I'm trying to live that life, though, just being in a bathtub forever. I guess he didn't cover, yeah, so there's another possibility. We talked about Napoleon a bit, but not all the crazy stuff he did. We gotta learn what happens when you invade Russia. Very important. Not gonna lie, I didn't realize that there was, like, a Star Wars Empire Strikes Back twist to this whole thing. I never looked into it. I just knew that there was some conflict for a bucket. The conflict was not start for the bucket, but there was a bucket, and the bucket was taken, right? Did I even watch it correctly? What if I'm wrong? See, bucket. That's what the bucket looked like, exactly like that. Is the bucket still around? That's what I want to know. I'm dead. Wait, yeah, when is this spinoff episode gonna come out? This is very important. Huge moment in history. I guess it's not over yet. Dude, I want to know, like, what is the time period? What, like, how long does it have to be before he'll cover something? I heard rule of thumb is 25 years. We might be getting the Two Tower episode soon. Spinoff episodes are my favorite. I'm gonna put that up there in the B tier. Longest video yet, 30 minutes. Dude, we need to hit 40. I want to see a 40 minute one. I don't know, maybe I'm just biased, but, like, the American history one, I don't know. Although I didn't, there was things that I didn't know. Like Lincoln was taking L's. Didn't realize how many L's Lincoln was taking at the very beginning. Okay, that there was L's in there that wasn't his fault, but you know, a lot of them were his fault. Lincoln was yelling at a lot of people. No references to how angry Lincoln was during that play though. Disappointed in that.
Hey, what?
Bro, there was a lot of shade thrown at Texas in this episode though. I had no idea they was gonna take some jabs at Texas. There was one pretty good jab. There was actually a good amount of stuff. I feel like they didn't talk about this too much when I was in school. So there was a good amount of stuff that I didn't know about. Moments before the saddest anime death of all time. I feel like that's all they're talking about. The comments are just talking about that, the GGs. This is one of those where part two, I think, was better than part one. I feel like around this time, he was just on fire, firing on all cylinders. Spoiler alert, this is probably my favorite episode. I'm just gonna do it right now. This is a part of the S tier. I guess technically this was a spinoff episode. We didn't get a part two though. Dude, I had no idea Henry was such a Chad though. In the beginning, dude, he was a Chad. But there was something clearly wrong with his gravy. I think it wasn't even his jawline too. It was like his legs specifically. How you get those legs? And yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I contributed a lot to, like, I thought it was just the wife eating. That's all I really knew about this guy, wife eating. I don't feel like they taught us. They never taught us. They never taught me in grade school. I never learned about Henry. And then the final two, the newest arc. Everyone's trying to predict the next episodes. I noticed that. Finally learned about this Chad too, Rasputin. Now I get the jokes, guys. Oh my God, is that Ed? It's Ed. One thing he'll never cover, the Balkans. That would have to be a 3-hour episode. Balkans. Maybe, I don't know why I always like part two. I don't know it. Maybe part two is just good. I think maybe just because longer episodes. Here's my tier list. I'm not giving anything an F, but I was having trouble finding anything to put down there. But yeah, favorite episodes, these are the most educational for me. I like these a lot. If I had to choose, I probably would choose the Henry one. It's one of the newest. I learned a lot. Maybe I like the Hilter one a lot just because it's probably, like, blocked in half the world. It's one of the most exclusive ones you could find. Now I finally understand more of the memes. I won't be completely in the dark as I usually am. Sometimes I really am like, wait, what? This is where you're getting all your info from. This is where Reddit gets their info. They just watch these videos and meme it. So obvious now. And big thanks to Douchebaggins,
Popcorn 2008,
Garland, Land of Gar,
Julius Cheeser,
can't think of a name,
Prime Minister Zeffy,
Peyton,
Fusion
Drew,
Wolf,
this is your dad, I am leaving you,
Manny 74,
my
Deezer
123,
every time communism has been tried.
Rats
and
Mac 3000.
Arian After
Pan,
Hours.
Qualavs.
Luxembourg.
Starlet.
Mayonnaise Incorporated.
Seth A.
Hipster
Lama.
Orlin
Like
Maxi
Stalling.
G.
Alphonso.
Alive.
San LBC.